Hi everybody. Today I'm going to be telling you about a way of preparing for the impending ban or phase out of single-use plastic bags that in Australia will pretty much occur from 1 July 2018. In fact, within the next few months, it looks as though most of Australia will have banned such plastic bags. There is no official national plastic bag ban yet. However, at the moment, single-use plastic bags are already banned in South Australia, the Northern Territory, Tasmania and the ACT. Recently, the West Australian, Queensland and Victorian governments have announced that they too will be banning such plastic bags from 1 July 2018. Now, this means that the only Australian state that will not have an official ban will be New South Wales. However, New South Wales will experience an effective ban due to the announcement by the major supermarket chains, namely Coles and Woolworths, that they themselves will be banning such plastic bags from 1 July 2018. So with this major overhaul with the way that people will be doing their shopping, what will be the options that will be available to shoppers? Well, firstly, shoppers will instead be compelled to purchase reusable plastic bags from their stores. Basically, these are plastic bags that are considerably thicker than the lightweight plastic bags. In this way, they will be an improvement over the single-use bags, which tend to fly all over the countryside and can get caught in waterways and in the stomachs of animals who ingest them. Secondly, there are the environmental or green bags, which have been around for quite some time now. The problem with these alternatives is that they are ultimately still derived from synthetic materials. The reusable plastic bags are made from, well, plastic, while the iconic green bags are also made from plastic, namely a material called polypropylene, which is a fuel-based plastic and is pretty indestructible. So while these bags won't get flown around the countryside, they will still end up in landfill and take years to biodegrade. The other aspect to these bags is they tend to get forgotten when we go to the supermarket, particularly when there's an unplanned visit, so we end up accumulating them en masse. What is a solution to some of these problems? Well, a solution that I propose is a Furoshiki bag or a bag made from a Furoshiki. All you need to do to be prepared for a trip to the shops is to have a basic square piece of fabric. You can either keep one in your bag, which you can whip out whenever you need and turn into a plastic bag on the spot, or you can have a pre-made Furoshiki bag, which is even more convenient. Or you can have a whole bunch of bags pre-made and ready to go for the weekly or the big shop. Once you get used to the convenience of a Furoshiki bag, particularly in terms of the amount they can hold, you'll wonder how you ever went through life without them. The other major advantage these bags have over the other options is they can be washed and sanitized like any other article of clothing. If they get dirty, it's not a problem. All you need to do is put it in the washing machine. Not only does this mean you don't have to worry about getting them soiled, it also means they can be sanitized. Now, this is a major improvement over the reusable plastic bags and especially the green bags, which can become quite unhygienic through repeated use and are not easy to clean. This is due to the fact that such bags are often used to carry a wide range of food items, some of which can leak, such as meats and dairy products, which can incubate bacteria. Not to mention that such bags are sometimes used for non-grocery purposes, such as a gym bag or a nappy bag, which have their own dubious hygiene credentials. However, with a Furoshiki bag, you don't have to worry about all these hygiene issues because all you can do is just put it in the washing machine and wash and sanitize it like any other article of clothing. So have a look at my website called Furoshiki Down Under, or my internet shop, which is on the Etsy website and is also called Furoshiki Down Under, for some ideas and for some inspiration. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact us.